Living Seed Media brings to you God's Word, which is His comprehensive equipment for changing lives. May the Lord impact your heart as you encounter His Word. For further inquiry or counsel, contact Peace House, P.O. Box 971, Boko, Benue State, Nigeria. Telephone numbers 0703-036-3659, 0703-768-1198. Email address lsmedia@livingseed.org or visit our website at www.livingseed.org. Let us sit back and listen as the servant of God brings forth the word of life.
I would just want you to follow me as we turn to the word of the Lord. Genesis chapter 22. That's a passage I know you are familiar with. And the story, you are also not unaware about it. But there was a question that was asked, and I'm praying that you will be an answer to that question. Genesis chapter 22. Just for you to have the context, I will read from verse 1 and I will get as far as verse 14. But our study, very briefly tonight, will be from verse 5, particularly unto verse 8. And it came to pass, after these things, that God did tempt Abraham, and said unto him, Abraham. And he said, Behold, here I am. And he said, Take now thy son, thy only son, Isaac, whom thou lovest, and get thee into the land of Moriah, and offer him there for a burnt offering upon one of the mountains which I will tell you of. And Abraham rose up early in the morning and saddled his ass, and he took two of his young men with him, and Isaac his son, and he clave the wood for the burnt offering. And he rose up, and he went unto the place of which God had told him. Then on the third day, Abraham lifted up his eyes, and he saw the place afar off. And Abraham said unto his young men, Abide ye here with the ass, and I and the lad will go yonder and worship and come again to you. And Abraham took the wood of the burnt offering and laid it upon his son, and he took the fire in his hand and a knife, and they went, both of them, together. And Isaac spake unto Abraham his father, and he said, My father. And he said, Here am I, my son. And he said, Behold the fire and the wood, but where is the lamb for a burnt offering? And Abraham said, My son, God will provide himself a lamb for a burnt offering. So they went, both of them, together. And they came to the place which God had told him of. And Abraham built an altar there, and he laid the wood in order, and bound Isaac his son, and laid him on the altar upon the wood. And Abraham stretched forth his hand, and he took the knife to slay his son. And the angel of the Lord called unto him out of heaven and said, Abraham, Abraham. And he said, Here am I. And he said, Lay not your hand upon the lad, neither do thou anything unto him. For now I know that thou fearest God, seeing that thou hast not withheld thy son, thy only son, from me. And Abraham lifted up his eyes and looked, and behold, behind him a ram caught in a thicket by his horns. And Abraham went and took the ram and offered him up for a burnt offering in the stead of his son. Verse 14. And Abraham called the name of that place Jehovah Jireh, as it is said to this day, in the mount of the Lord it shall be seen. Permit me to stop there. I don't want to get into the rest of that passage tonight. The Lord may be leading us into it differently. Father, we ask you to speak to us. We ask you that your word will mix with faith in our hearts. We ask that quietly tonight, and gently, and yet by the power of your Spirit, reach out to our hearts. Make us an answer to this great question. Where is the lamb for the burnt offering? Where is the lamb for the burnt offering? Father, tonight we are praying that the fire, the wood, the altar, as wonderful as they are, they do not release an aroma to you until there is a lamb on that altar. Father, I ask that even tonight, as early as this meeting is beginning, may you find lambs for this burnt offering in the name of Jesus Christ. This is a story, like I said, you know, and there are many issues that we could raise looking at the story of the life of Abraham. And there are many things that we could learn from his life. But this particular day, I perceive the Lord will want us to welcome you unto this very, very important, crucial encounter with God. Something is about to happen. Something is about to take place in our generation. And God is asking, where is the lamb for the burnt offering? Heaven is mobilized to do something new in our day. The time for God to visit our land has come. Though the devil is raging here and there with diversities of problems, yet the time for God to arise has come. The time for fire to break forth in the nations is here. The day of a divine visitation, a revival such that we have never seen before. Unprecedented move of God has come. The time when both in the sanctuary and in the palace, in the laboratory and in the market, word of the Lord will be sounding and sounding loud. The time is coming when God is about to gather in the harvest just before the appearing of his son, even our Lord Jesus Christ. But for this, that God is mobilized and ready to do in our day, there was but a question: but where is the lamb for the burnt offering? Where is the lamb for the burnt offering? Last year, when God brought us and the Holy Spirit began to speak to us about the dimension of what God wants to do, he said, it's not by power, it's not by might, but by my spirit. We left with a great sense that a time of divine multiplication is knocking. And we went on, and the Holy Spirit now began to speak and say, yes, but there can be no fire that will spread the aroma of revival unless there are living sacrifices. And so God is saying, gather unto me my saints that have made covenant with me by sacrifice. When God spoke to Abraham, first to get out of his country, he did. When God spoke to him to let go his kindred and all that he could cling to, he let go. When for many years he had waited to have a child and he couldn't, and he found himself sleeping with the house girl Hagar, and they produced Ishmael, and for 13 solid years something broke in his communion with God, because he thought that Ishmael was an answer to his cry. But when God came after 13 years, he said, my covenant is with you. I have nothing to do with Ishmael. The son of the bondwoman will not have a part in the inheritance. And it came to pass that God said, cast out that boy. And I saw how Abraham, in obedience to God, and I can imagine the pain of maintaining a relationship with God and of not allowing any obstacle between him and the Savior, when he gathered whatever he could and put on the head of that boy and the mother and sent them away, so that he could keep his relationship with God. He was willing to get rid of Hagar and Ishmael, and they left. Only for God to come back. And he said, Abraham. And Abraham said, yes, Lord, here am I. What will you have me to do? What exactly is the next agenda for me? What is your will for my life? Here am I, Lord. And as Abraham waited, he heard what he never expected to hear. Take now your son, your only son, Isaac, whom you love, the one you love, the one you cherish, the one that is the hope of your life, the one that is the expression and the definition of your life, the one whom you love. Take him unto a mountain that I will show you, and offer him to me there as a burnt offering. Because tonight is not the night for me to analyze all that takes place for a man who wants to obey God. All the contemplations of the heart, all the issues, all the cries. How Abraham must have been panting throughout the night and say, "Oh God, oh God, if this is your will, I love you more than this, I will offer him." You will have asked, what of the wife? What of Sarah? That great woman of God, who from the very beginning of their marriage has decided to follow her husband to anywhere, to follow her husband to anything. When the husband said, the Lord said, "I should move," he said, "Well, if God told you to move, I'm going with you. If the Lord said, go here, I'll go with you." When they migrated to Egypt, that woman was obedient. When they came out, that woman said, "Well, my husband, I know you need a baby. If it is not through me that you are going to have a baby, there's this girl, you can go there." It was painful. This woman, I'm sure that Abraham must have said, "There's a journey I'm going to take. There's a mountain God is asking me to go to make an offering. And that offering is a very, very costly offering. But I will do it by God's faith. I will do it because I know, even if he dies, God is able to raise him from the dead if he is still the son of the promise. And I don't know how Sarah must have said, "Well, I never expected to have a child. It ceased to be with me after the manner of women for many years, for more than 45 years, before God came and said, I will smile. And if he has also decided that my laughter will be laid on the altar, it's okay." And this journey started. And I wonder why they were going to travel for 3 days for them to get to the place of the sacrifice. 3 days of contemplation. 3 days of hard journey. 3 days of difficult movement. And I know that some of you that travel from very, very far places, some of you travel for more than 3 days to arrive here. Some of you face terrible roads to arrive here. Some of us, you caught different flights, long flights for you to come to this place. But that journey will not be useful if Abraham did not actually get to the place of sacrifice. After 3 days, when he saw the mantle in the place afar off, he knew that even though he had been traveling with the company of his servants, going to the place of sacrifice, you don't go in company of people. You go alone. I pray that God will help you in the course of this meeting to focus on what God is demanding from my life and from your life. I am hoping, oh God, that the Spirit of the living God will concentrate on each one of us in the name of Jesus Christ. The Bible said, when they came to that point, Abraham was going to remove every hindrance, all the sympathizers that will make it impossible for him to obey God, all the people that say, sir, don't do it. He told all of them, he said, you people, you will stay here. I and this lad, we will go yonder. I will go a little yonder. Jesus, Lord, must be sweeter. I will go a little yonder, yeah. I will dig a little deeper. Jesus, Lord, can be sweeter. I want to dig a little deeper yet. I will dig a little deeper. Jesus, Lord, must be sweeter. I will dig a little deeper yet. I and the Lord, we will go yonder and we will worship the Lord. He made it in such a way that he did not express in a way that everybody would think that there's a problem. Something has happened to Abraham. So as they were going, the very 1 million question, Isaac said, Dad. And the father said, yes, I'm here. You know, their discussion started becoming very grave now. They were going. And Abraham's, his thought was beginning to race to the mount. I imagine he was thinking, so how do I do it now? How do I catch this boy now and put him on the altar? I hope he will not struggle with me. I hope he will not push me down. I, God, and I want to do it. But he's already a grown-up boy now. What do I do, oh God? And in the middle of his thoughts, Isaac broke in and said, Dad, as if Dad was absent-minded. And Abraham said, yes, I'm here. And the boy said, I want to ask you an important question, sir. Here is the wood, and here is the fire. Where is the lamb for the burnt offering? You told me that we are going to make a burnt offering. I have seen the fire. I have seen the wood. And I have seen the knife. But where is the lamb? And Abraham said something that we may not be able to understand now. He said, God will provide for himself the lamb for the burnt offering. when we get there, we will see how it will be.
That's what he said.
Say, let's go. When we get there, we will discover the Lamb. And Isaac himself began to wonder, could this Lamb, could it be me? Could it be me that heaven is waiting for? Could it be me? Could it be me that God needed to take for his purpose to be established on the face of the earth? And they went on together. The Bible said, and both of them went on. You know, as I read my Bible, I see some silent issues. Look at how the Bible put it. So they went, both of them, together. So I saw that when it said, so they went, both of them, together. I thought it could have been something to say, and so they went on. The Holy Spirit needed to note, so they went, both of them, together. As if from that point, everybody is taking a journey now. It looks as if from that point, Abraham is moving to do something that he will never recover from again. And Isaac is going to face a destiny that he may never be able to change again. But they went together. And I'm praying that you will come along to the place of divine visitation. I pray that the Holy Ghost will do something in our midst that will become an answer and a blessing to our generation in the name of Jesus Christ. So as they were going, I can see uneasy quiet. I can see contemplation in the heart. So when they got to the mount, and Abraham confirmed that this is the place, God said, this is the place. And once he knew that this is where this offering is going to take place, he started arranging the wood in order. He started building the altar. I think Isaac must have supported him as they were laying the wood. But the question that was not answered was, where is the Lamb? When they finished laying the wood on the altar, the knife had been sharpened. While Isaac is still saying, Father, we have laid the altar. We have set the wood in order. Here is the knife. Here is the fire. But where is the Lamb? And Abraham said, I love you, but I love him more than you. I wish to hold you, but I would rather hold him, even if he takes you away. For the purposes of God to come to pass, you are that Lamb. Do you know that heaven was quiet until this time? Do you know that angels were watching? Do you know that all the hosts of heaven were all at alert? Do you know that all the host of heaven, they were all like this? Will he do it? Will he obey God? Will he let go? Will God have his way in this man's life? Will he prove that God has found a man that they can use to become a blessing to all the generations of the earth? Will this man become the man that we have been looking for since Adam fell in the wilderness? With this man, will he do it? Will he take this decision? Will he obey God? The heavens were all waiting. The hosts were all waiting. And I want to tell you, hell was also at alert. Wherever the devil was standing, he must be saying, I tried to hinder him. I tried to divert him. I tried to confuse him. But this man is too resolved. He's too resolved to go with God. I am afraid of what will come out of this man if he did this thing. Maybe this is the seed that will bruise the head of the serpent that God was speaking about. Hi. While angels are watching, demons are jittering, and Abraham standing, he reached out his hand and he took Isaac. I was going to talk not about Abraham tonight. I was going to talk about that lamb. And as he took him, and I was wondering if Isaac wanted to fight his father at his age. You know, when you see death and you see knife coming on your neck, a supernatural strength rises to fight. Am I right? But I saw something that could not be explained. And they took Isaac, wow, on the altar. And the father took the rope and was tying him there and was wrapping the rope around him. And I look at Isaac looking at the eyes of his father. And I hear him say, if I be the lamb that must be offered for the covenant of God to take place on the face of the earth through you, so be it. If it is my life that you need for the will of God to be done in your generation, let it be so, Lord. And that moment, I think Isaac must have closed his eyes. He must have offered his final prayer. I don't know whether you can put words to his prayer. He must have said, Father, the father of my father, I cannot stand between you and him. You gave me to him, and if he has willingly decided to offer me to you, I surrender. And as the knife was coming, as far as Isaac was concerned, he was already dead. And as far as Abraham was concerned, Isaac was already offered. And as he was bringing down the knife, and God was waiting, God was watching, Will he do it? When God saw that, yes, he was not going to withhold his only son, God said, yes, now I know. And I was saying, God, you mean you did not know that Abraham feared you when he left his country? You mean you were not convinced that this man loved you and feared you when he obeyed you and sent Hagar out? You mean you are not sure that he loved you when he allowed Lot to take all the properties? You mean you are not yet convinced that he loved you when he sent Ishmael out of the country? Lord, he said, now I know. This night, God is asking a question. I am about to move in your generation, but where is the lamb for the burnt offering? Where is that life that I can use to bring about my glory in the land of the living? Where is the lamb for the burnt offering? As I draw this to a stop tonight, I trust that the Spirit of God will be speaking beyond what I could say at this point. And so the Bible said, God said, stop, don't touch the lad. Now I know that there's nothing you can withhold from me. Now I know there's nothing you will keep from laying at my feet. Now I know. Now I know that you feared me. Now I know that there is nothing that is too precious in your life that you will not let me have. Now I know. Even though Isaac was no more slaughtered. Are you hearing me? Eh? I want you to imagine what must have happened, because that's where I want to stop. By the time he was untying Isaac, and Isaac stood up, and I saw Isaac looking at that altar that could have been his burial ground, something must have happened. Isaac said, I am a sacrifice, but that I've been kept alive. As I see Isaac walking back home, Isaac said, I was already dead, actually. I no longer belong to this man. I am a sacrifice that God decided to keep alive only for himself. And Abraham, as they were coming back, he must have been looking at Isaac, and Isaac must have been looking at his father, and something has changed in between the two of them. And Isaac now knows that, yes, if not for God, I should have been gone. And Abraham said, he's already offered to God. Unless that God wanted to keep him alive for himself, I have nothing in him again. I have offered him. Where is the lamb for the burnt offering tonight? There's one more verse I need to read so that we can pray. Psalm 51 and verse 17. Psalm 51 and verse 17. The sacrifices of God are what? A broken spirit. A broken and a contrite heart, O God, thou wilt not despise. The sacrifices of God, they are a broken spirit. A broken and a contrite heart, thou wilt not despise. As I stop on this note here tonight, here is the wood. Here is the knife. Here is the fire. Where is that lamb for the burnt offering? Where is that life that is offered to God without reservation? Where is that brother, that sister that saw God? I will withhold nothing from you again. For your will to be done in my generation. For the aroma of your glory to break forth. And for the fire of God to burn in the nations. Here am I. Here am I. Here am I. But this life that will be accepted is a broken and a contrite heart. A heart that is not hiding any sin. A heart that is saying, oh God, if my life will be a blessing to my generation, why should I withhold it from you? Take this life tonight and let it be consecrated for your use. That Abraham became the father of the nations, and that he became the father of our faith, and that the savior of mankind came through his loins, was because what he could have withheld, he let go. And if you were going to become an answer to our generation, God is asking tonight, where is the lamb? Will you answer and say, God? Or will you be that boy that say, well, I have many things to do with my life. I have my ambition. When I become that, if there's any leftover, let God take it. Or you are saying, oh Lord, even in the prime of my life, in the prime of my years, take my life. Whatever it is that this life could become in your hand, I want to lay it down. I want to be an offering in your hand. As we shall rise in prayer, we have just entered this meeting, and yet God is saying, here is the wood, here is the knife, here is the fire. Where is the lamb for the burnt offering? Where is that life that is saying, Lord, take my life and let it be used for your glory. Every stubbornness, every wrong thing, break it and let me be an answer to my generation. Let me not be one that the devil looks at and say, yes, this one again, as head to himself, so that the will of God might be postponed in this age. And Jesus stands here and is knocking, and he said, my son, can I have a light? Can I have this heart of yours? Can you lay this life down at my feet, that your generation might find an answer? Where is the lamb? Where is the lamb? I'm not going to do more than this tonight, but I'm hearing God demanding, where are those men and women that are saying, Lord, take my life, let it be consecrated to you, take my moments, take my days, that out of me an aroma of life may break out, that out of my life my generation may find answer, they might find God. Say, now I know that you fear God. Now I know. Now I know. Now I know. Now I know. Barika Shanta Bakoro Moske. When will God know that you love him? When will God be convinced that you will not hold something back from him? When will this light created by God, when will it bring a sweet aroma to the Lord? When will this life become a blessing, a turning point in this generation? We are praying right now. You might need to close your eyes and pray. You might need to answer their question. Is the Spirit of God knocking on your heart and say, but what do you want to do with a life that is not handed over to God? What do you want to do with a life that is struggling with the Savior? When will God smell a sweet aroma from your own heart? We are praying, please. Please bow your head in prayer. And if the Lord is drawing on your heart, say, today. Today is that day that God is saying, where is the lamb for the offering? Where is this light that I could use for my glory? If you are standing on your feet, to come and say, Lord, take my life just as I am, without one plea. If there is something you can do with a life, if there is a way you can help my life, here am I, oh God. Taroboshanda bakaura masaila. Taroboshanda bakaura masaila. Some of you have lived for several years and you have only served the devil. Your life is being burnt out for several things that have never been of benefit. And yet you are not burned to become an offense in your generation. You were born that by your life heaven should rejoice. How are you growing to become a source of regrets in your own generation. Where is the lamb for this burnt offering? And for whom do you want to reserve your life if you will not give it to Jesus? For whom do you want this your years to be consumed? And what has the devil paid you all the years that you have walked in disobedience? What did you gain? I want to leave a call tonight. Said the sacrifices of our God is a broken heart and a contrite spirit. If you hear the voice of the Lord here tonight, the Bible says, harden not your heart. This is the day that God has ordained, and God is waiting. Heaven is waiting. Angels are waiting. Will you hand over that life to God? Satan is also waiting. Can't we make him to postpone his surrender? Can we make him to go away so that we can damage his life? Are you in between two opinions tonight? Is the Spirit of God knocking on your heart? My son, give me your heart. Wherever you are standing, the Spirit of God is still drawing your heart and say, tonight is the night to hand over. Tonight is the night to place your life in the hand of him who is able to preserve it. The greater Son of the living God, he went to Calvary, shed his precious blood, and gave us his life that you might be saved. That you may not perish, you may not go to hell. Everyone is asking tonight, where is the lamb? Where is the lamb? We have seen the fire, we have seen the wood, we have even seen the knife. But where is the lamb for the burnt offering? While you are praying, the choir, you are going to sing that song again. And if you still need to make a response, whether you are in the gallery, or you are in the aisles, or you are in the other tent, wherever you are, you just need to stand before God and say, Lord, I will no longer keep this life back. I will no longer withhold my life from your hand. I will no longer be an instrument of offense in my generation. There must be an aroma coming out of this life. I surrender it. I lay it at the feet. Where are you? If you are already coming, just lift up your two hands and say, Lord, I'm coming to you. If you are stepping down, please do that quickly. We will not have time tonight to wait. You are saying, Lord, take this life finally. The sacrifices of God are a broken spirit. A broken heart and a contrite spirit. God bless you. Open my eyes to see Jesus seated upon the throne. Holy Ghost. Are you coming down? Please come quickly. And as you are coming, find a space, please. And lift those hands to God. And say, Lord, take this life. Just take it. Just take my heart, oh God. God bless you. God bless you. Do quick. A lamb for the offering. God bless you. God bless you. Come down quickly. Just walk down very quickly. Create a space for those that are coming, please. Holy Ghost. God bless you if you are coming here. bless you quickly tonight.
Jesus,
in my life,
my life today.
God bless you, my friend. Out here, just lift those two hands to God and say, Lord, take it, Lord. Holy Ghost, oh, Holy Ghost, do it again. Oh, do it again. Seated upon the throne. For the last time, Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, do it again. Oh, do it again. To see Jesus, who is seated on the throne. So as you raise those hands to the Lord, can you tell God, Lord, take me as I am. I don't even consider myself worthy of you, but since it pleased you to demand the sacrifice of my life, you will purify it for yourself. But on my part, I surrender myself to you. I hand myself over unto you, God. Take my life and let it be consecrated, O Lord, unto you. Did I consider it a right for me to seek anything with my own life? To aspire to anything with my life? To nurse an ambition that is personal to me? I surrender all. Lord, I surrender all. I hand over my life completely, totally, hook, line, and sinker. Wholesale, I hand over my life unto you, O God. Everything that defines me, it's no longer under my control. That you may consume whatever you must consume in my life to bring you the aroma that will announce your sweetness to this generation. That you may do whatever is necessary to transform my life into a burnt offering on your altar. I don't care what goes now because I'm not mine anymore. Whatever you decide for my life, you have every right so to do, for I am all yours. Lord, from now, I surrender unto you. I surrender unto you. I don't want to exist any longer. I want to be history from now. Yes, I'm going to walk away from here, but no longer existing to myself, no longer alive the way I used to be. I will be a living sacrifice already offered.
now ready for whatever you may choose concerning me. Now it is to live for your purpose. Now is for you to have your way with my life. For I am all yours. Lord, take my life and let it be. Whatsoever you may choose, so let it be, O God. This is the prayer I offer to you as I lay my hand upon this offering to say, Lord, collect it. Let your fire consume it. Let the zeal of the Lord of hosts consume it. And let the aroma be to your glory. Father, have your way tonight. And have your way with me forever and ever. Let even my physical death be only a fuller release of my life as a sacrifice in your hand. Begin this with me, but let it ever follow forever and ever. Thank you, Heavenly Father. To you be all the glory forever and ever. Blessed be thy name. In the name of Jesus. As you still raise that hand, I want to pray with you now. Father, it is one thing to make an offering unto you. It's totally another thing, another matter entirely, for you to accept the offering. We plead with you that our offering will be acceptable unto you. We plead with you, O God, in your mercy, that you will send down the fire to consume this offering, evidence that you have accepted it from our hand in the name of Jesus. An offering slaughtered, left on the altar, that does not receive the fire of God's acceptance, will only begin to get rotting and smelly. Our offering shall not become smelly. Our offering is not for the vultures to come to eat it. Our offering is not for decay, for decomposition. It is for the consumption of your fire in the name of Jesus. Let the fire of glory, the fire of heaven, let it descend upon our lives from this night in the name of Jesus. For this to happen, you will open the heavens unto us. We will begin to see Jesus. When Stephen offered his life a sacrifice unto you, you opened the heavens. He saw Jesus standing at your right hand. From tonight, visions of heaven will be our own portion in the name of Jesus. And it will not end with this retreat. It will accompany us all our days in the name of Jesus. Therefore, let the open heavens be our perpetual experience from this night forward in the name of Jesus. Were there difficulties in our life that hindered us from hearing you, from seeing you, from receiving from you, from understanding you, from being led of you? Your own sacrifice must be tied to the horn of your altar. Connect us to you permanently from tonight in the name of Jesus. As you begin to release your heart unto your people, we will be in the front line of those who receive it loud and clear, who understand it very, very vividly in the name of Jesus. Every obstruction that stood in our way, in our communion with you, break it tonight, because we are all yours and we are connected to your purpose for this generation. Flow to us in a manner that is unhindered in the name of Jesus. Father, you will definitely begin to wash us up. You will begin to clean us in and out. You begin to cut our lives into the proper pieces that will be exposed to the fire of your word. Begin this work, complete it. Let it be thorough. Let your dealing be very, very thorough with each one of us from tonight. In the name of Jesus, we have stepped forward in order to signal to you that we are ready to go with you all the way. Do not stop at any point. Go with us all the way. Perfect your labor upon our lives. Achieve your purpose with us in the name of Jesus. Blessed be your holy name for doing beyond all that we could ask or imagine. To you be glory forever and ever. Thank you, Father, for answering us. Blessed be your holy name. For in Jesus' name we have prayed.